So the results of the elections in Berlin 1 month ago confirmed our position. The PDS, who is part of the government coalition in Berlin together with the Social Democrats, they have been responsible for massive social cuts, for privatization of hospitals and other things in Berlin. They lost half of the absolute number of their votes. Now they are trying to be again part of the government. And on the other side, like Joe just reported, we gained 40,000 votes for a very fighting campaign, for a very fighting party against social cuts and privatization, against wage cuts. We received 14 WASG members. 14 WASG members were elected on the district councils, three from them are SAB members, and I think that was a really good result for the fact that WASG was standing in the election for the first time, and our standing in the election also prevented the Nazis to winning seats in parliament. So the formation of the WASG was an expression of the first wave of generalized protests in Germany, because there have been many, many attacks on the living standards of the working class in the last year in Germany. For instance, the introduction of Hartz IV by the SPD-led or Social Democrats-led federal government 3 years ago made poverty a mass phenomenon in Germany. So Hartz IV means forced labor for 1 euro per hour wages were introduced, and benefits for the unemployed were cut to an extremely low level. So there's a new report which has shown that social inequality in Germany is higher than in most of the other EU countries. There's a social ranking, and in this social ranking Germany placed the 21st out of all European countries. So, and at the same time, there are further attacks on healthcare and pensions, and there are mass redundancies at the moment despite increasing profits. For instance, the Allianz Insurance, this insurance company made an increased profit by 30% last year, and now they want to sack 5,000 workers. So that's a normal situation at the moment in Germany. And at the end of 2003, there was a large demonstration against the government, against all the attacks on the living standard of the working class, organized by trade unionists from below against the trade union bureaucracy. And with this demonstration, it was a starting point of a wave of workplace and trade union struggles. There were the spontaneous mass protests of the unemployed against this Hartz IV law in the summer of 2004, which came as a surprise for everyone. 100,000 unemployed people turned out every Monday on the streets and just shouted, Hartz IV has to be abolished. So, but the trade union leadership, they didn't call on the people to participate in this movement in order to back up the SPD-led federal government. And for this reason, the Monday demonstration came to an end, and they had no significant consequences. And I just tell you the story of this demonstration and so on, because from the decline of this movement, many people just draw the conclusion that it is necessary to build a new political force against social cuts, against Hartz IV. And therefore the WASG, when it was formed 2.5 years ago, there was an initial enthusiasm towards this new party, within a short time the party had 10,000 new members. And the strength of this party, of the WASG, was its links with the trade unions, and its character as a party which is absolutely new and which is not involved in any government. So, and it also marked the beginning of a necessary break between a section of a trade union trade unions and the social democrats. So the SAV had been arguing, or we just welcomed this process, but we have been arguing for a new workers' party from the middle of the 90s because of the bourgeoisification, right? of the SPD, of the Social Democrats, and we saw the WASG as a first point of reference for the formation for future mass party in Germany, in the, which represents the working class. And our opinion was that the new party must be four things, or should have be four Eigenschaften. Okay, like this, okay. It should be first open, second democratic, third should be militant, a fighting party, and fourth it should be a socialist party. And we did not make our positions preconditions for working in this new party, but we made very clear that today, with a massive class struggle from above and the more limited room for reformist policies as compared to 30 years ago, a socialist program is necessary in order to withstand the capitalist crisis and the pressure so we are standing under. So this was also one of the most important lessons of the later conflict which developed around the election campaign in Berlin. So in summer 2005, Oskar Lafontaine, the former SPD leader, joined the WASG. And because of this, the party got a higher profile, especially amongst West German, the working class in West Germany. But on the other hand, he orientated the WASG towards a joint candidacy with the PDS in the general election in 2005, and towards a merger with this PDS. And the PDS is a party with no attraction, or the party doesn't attract fresh layers or people who are quite newly involved in struggles, because it's the old Stalinist party which is also involved into in Mecklenburg-Vorpommern in Berlin. So so at the beginning there was an initial reaction of enthusiasm among left activists for the idea of a left unity between WASG and PDS, but the disillusionment soon set in view of the politics carried out by the PDS in government. And because of this, the conflict which developed around the issue in, of the elections in Berlin was therefore a conflict of the future direction of the new left party which was to be formed. So in Berlin, the PDS has been in government since 2001, and there they have privatized, for instance, more than 100,000 apartments. They cut 20,000 jobs in the public sector, and they are responsible for wage cuts of 10%, and they are also responsible for the creation of over 30,000 of these 1 euro jobs. And their main argument is that they are making a contribution to consolidate the budget of Berlin, since Berlin is effectively bankrupt with debts of over 60 billion euros. So the Berlin WASG, on the other hand, just argues that it's not the unemployed and not the workers who are responsible for the crisis, who are not responsible that the profit, that the bosses make all the profits, and that they should pay now for the crisis. And the Berlin WASG argues that resistance is necessary to change the balance of forces in whole society.